Hey guys, glad you could make it onto the webinar today. My name is Jessica and I'm the PR director here at Postcard Mania. I'm today's webinar organizer and Joyjin Duza is your presenter. I want to go over just a few housekeeping things before we begin. If you cannot hear me or see the screen, just let me know with a quick chat comment in the chat section of the control panel on your screen. You can see it on the right. So don't be shy. If you have a question, just type it in and send it. I will either answer your question as we go, or I'll save it for Joy. We will get to your question at the end, so just sit tight. All right, let me check the chat. Looks good. Okay, it looks like you all can hear me okay. I think we're ready to get started. Your presenter today is Joyjin Duza. Joy is the founder and CEO of Postcard Mania, a marketing company that specializes in lead generation. Joy grew her business from a small startup in 1998 with only a phone, a computer, and postcard marketing. That means no capital injections or venture capitalist backing. And today, Joy has taken that small startup and turned it into an industry leader. Postcard Mania employs 210 people and generates over $49 million in annual revenue. She's regularly featured in Dental Economics Magazine, Business Insider, Inc. Magazine, Entrepreneur, and more. So here's your presenter today, Joyjin Duza.
Thanks, Jessica. Hi, everybody. I'm very happy to be here to do this webinar for you, and thank you for attending. Thank you for your interest. So we're going to go over today how to close 80% more sales with low-cost automated follow-up systems. I'm going to go over a bunch of different things with you, not just that. So let's just get rolling. So let's see if I can figure this out. There we go. So this, I'm the lady in the picture holding Lulu, the Maltese, and that's my family. That was our Christmas card last year. My two boys don't live with us anymore. Actually, one of them said to me, do we have to keep showing up here for Christmas card photos every year? We don't live here anymore. And I said, well, get married and make your own family and then make your own card. But until then, you have to be on my card. But they both work here at Postcard Mania, so I get to see them every day. I'm really super lucky. And, of course, the furries are my my three children that live at home still, and that's my wonderful husband, Sam. So back in the day when I started this company, it was me and a couple of people in a small cottage on Turner Street in Clearwater, Florida, and that's the cottage we were in. And I couldn't even afford to have a real trade show booth made, so I sort of jerry-rigged one together and put up posters and pictures and things in it. And today, that photo is actually a couple years old now, but that's our new headquarters that we had built in 2009. We moved in, and you can see that in this picture right here, you're sort of driving into the parking garage, and this is our printing plant, which we had since 2005, actually. And this was all a big backyard back here that we wound up building our current facility, our current offices in that backyard. It just worked out that we had that awesome backyard. And now we actually bought the property right behind us and added a big digital press back there. So that's what happened in the last 19 years. We went from this to this. And of course, I did it all with marketing, a lot of trial and error. And every time I would learn something as a business owner, I would write about it. And I wrote so many articles, and I kept putting these articles up on my little website that was more like a brochure back then, of course. And the word blog didn't even exist yet. And I just started putting all these articles there to help my customers and potential customers with their marketing. So I really do enjoy teaching everything that I learned to help you grow your business too. So the first thing is I like to simplify what is marketing and what are we trying to do here. So what we're trying to do is with our marketing is to generate a lead. And once we get someone interested in what we have to offer, whether it's with postcards or a billboard or whatever, we have to capture the identity of that person. I mean, maybe they call up on the phone and you ask them for their name and phone number and all their contact information, or maybe they go to your website first, which is why I'm showing a lead capture form in the graphic here. But people don't really like to fill out forms online, so I'm going to go over some best practices with you today to get that form filled out. And once you have that captured identity of that interested person, it's your job to follow up with them. And follow up can be time consuming, especially if it's not systemized. And I want to show you some automated follow up that will help you get many more touches to that lead without you having to do anything, because the more they actually get followed up with, the faster you're going to be able to close that sale. So let's start with lead generation. So again, what is a lead? I would say that a lead is anyone who sees your advertisement and has some interest in what you have to offer. But of course, if you don't have their contact information, that lead is kind of valueless to you because you can't control what happens with that person. So what's happened over time since I started my business is people are able to go online and do all their due diligence about a product or a service or your business without ever calling you on the phone. And that red line basically indicates or represents technological advancement, and the blue line is consumers calling a company to have their questions answered. It's just not necessary anymore. So what happens is like anybody who's interested in what you have, anyone who saw your ad, if they have any interest, almost 100% of them are going to go to your website before doing anything to contact you. They're just going to go to your website. And statistically, 96% of people who visit a website leave that website without doing anything. So let's say you sent out direct mail and you generated 500 leads or 500 people that were interested in what the postcard said on it. And those 500 people, let's say 490 of them went to your website. Well, 485 of them, 480 of them are going to leave your website without doing a darn thing. So we want to figure out how do we get them to fill out that form? How do we get them to do something? How do we get them to engage with you or want to be in communication with you? So we'll talk about that. So first, I want to go over direct mail. I feel like if you're on this website, you're probably already good on direct mail. You know direct mail works, or maybe you're still in the I don't know camp. So I'll just give you some hard data. So per Epsilon, direct mail yields an average of 13-to-1 return on investment. But I don't particularly like that statistic because it's totally different depending on what industry you're in, and that's an average across all industries. And I can tell you stories. I mean, I can tell you about some of the craziest returns on investment with like the tiniest amounts of money spent and huge, enormous amounts of money made, but that might not be the industry you're in. Like if I'm starting to want to go into the buying houses industry because these people, oh my goodness, we know how to get them huge, huge, massive return on investment. But that's just not true for every single industry. And if you call Postcard Mania and you have a product that's not, you don't use postcards to sell a book. None of my reps are going to sell you postcards if you're trying to sell something that's $29.99 or $39.99. You're just not going to get the return investment that you need. But let's take a look at direct mail in comparison to PPC or email. First, I'll say what PPC is. PPC stands for pay per click, and that's just when you look for something on Google and then the first top few are paid. They're advertisers that are right there at the top, and if you click on that, the advertiser is paying for that click, and that's a particular kind of marketing using Google. It's also called Google AdWords. So if you compare direct mail to PPC or email, you're going to get a 900% better response when you're dealing with raw prospects, meaning people who know nothing about your business and they've never been to your website and they don't know you. Obviously, email works amazing to your house list, to people that already know you. 60% of consumers have visited a promoted website because of direct mail they've received, and 75% of consumers try a business for the first time because of direct mail. So those are some things to think with that aren't coming from me personally. And I want to show you that, I totally practice what I preach. We spend a lot of money on on direct mail and on marketing in general. We spend about $80,000 to $85,000 every single week on marketing. And obviously, we didn't spend that much back in 2003. It was much less. But you can see that as we increased our marketing spend, our revenue went up. Now, if you look over here from 2008 to 2009, everybody on this call remember 2008 and 2009? It's when everything went to hell in a handbasket. And we had just moved into this building we're in, and it was like our worst year because we were down 15%. And I cut our marketing budget. Actually, it was at the some of my executives that talked me into doing it, and I'll never, ever, ever do it again because we cut the marketing budget and the stats were down. And if you look at what happened, we put it back up, 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 and our revenue just kept continuing to climb. So I'm a true believer. I don't just, you know, hawk it to my customers and swear by it, but don't believe in it. I truly, truly believe in it. And I'll show you a customer of ours. This is their graph. This is the green line is postcards mailed, and the blue line is people who registered for their online college. So they weren't doing anything with postcards, and they were getting sometimes, you know, this is 50 up here, so under 50 a week of registrations. No, under 50 a month, I'm sorry, of people registering for the college. And when they started doing postcards, you can see what started to happen here. They were consistently every single month sending out postcards, and the numbers just totally boomed. And what happened is they had the idea, well, goodness gracious, we're doing so well, let's not send out postcards 1 month, and let's not send out postcards another month. We'll just do it like every other month, and we won't do as much when we do it, or maybe. And then here they started to realize their numbers were going down. They were like, well, we better not do zero, but we'll still do a small amount. And we got them to increase, go back up to where they were really doing well, like where their numbers were really high. And they started seeing more consistent registrations as they were more consistent with their postcards. Now, this next one is one of my faves, because this gentleman, this doctor, Ahmed Khanna at Patuxent Dental, he shares his revenue numbers with me, and he's very kind to do that so that I can show off what has happened for him using direct mail. He bought his practice in 2007, and the only advertising he was doing was yard signs and Yellow Page ads, and he was pretty frustrated, so he called us and started mailing in 2010, 6,000 pieces every month. And he saw, you know, a slow incline of new patients coming into his practice. And then we got him to increase it to 12,000 pieces per month. And he saw another really good increase from doubling up. And then when we came out with Direct Mail 2.0, which I'm going to go over that with you later in the call, that's the automated follow-up. When he added that to his marketing mix, he just saw, and he does it every single solitary month, the guy is consistent, and he's just such a good advocate for being consistent. And he's just doing amazing. He's just getting, I think I'm going to sneak visit him when he has his grand opening. He's having it in September. He had to get a new building, and he had to hire like 3 dentists. So I love bragging about him. He's a good guy. Now, you may say, why shouldn't I just use pay-per-click alone? Even though I showed you how much better direct mail does, I'll just give you a little bit of information to think with. We did a 3-mile radius in Irvine, California, a very populated area, to see how many consumer addresses there were there, and there were over 61,000. And in that same 3-mile radius, there were 93 accountants. And then we went to look and see how many people were searching for tax planner, accounting services, tax preparer, and all that. And you can see that the numbers are very, very low compared to how many people are in the area and how much competition there is. There's 93 CPAs that are all going to be clamoring for these leads, and there's just not enough per CPA to make a dent in your business. This next one we did was a less populated area. This is Iowa City, Iowa. They had only under 30,000 consumer addresses in a 3-mile radius, and they had 13 landscapers all fighting for, you know, about 100 leads per month if you add up all of these, if they do fence installation or tree service. Not all of them do. So it's just not enough business, especially, I mean, you're not going to close every single person. They're all going after the exact same people. But not everybody is doing direct mail. So it doesn't take that much for you to really outmarket and outperform your competitors. I would recommend that you find out what your competitors are doing. If you could get onto their mailing list, if you can call their business and blind shop them and see if how much they follow up with you, that would really let you see what you're up against. So I highly, highly recommend that. So now we're going to talk about lead capture. This is a very, very interesting subject. So when you do a direct mail piece, you want to make sure, I don't know if this has ever happened to you, where you get something in the mail and then you go to the website and the website doesn't look anything like the direct mail piece and you're not even like 100% certain if you're at the right website or if you typed it in correctly. So that's what. So we recommend that whatever you're mailing out, as soon as they go to, whether it's your homepage or whether it's a specific page called a landing page. I want to tell you a little bit about what that is. A landing page is a page inside your website. It doesn't have to be inside your website, but it's easy to put it there. But you don't necessarily have a link, an internal link on your site that goes there. You're driving traffic either from your pay-per-click or from your direct mail to a specific page that continues the communication that the direct mail piece started. So here it says you earned it, we'll help you keep it, $30 off any income tax preparation. So then they go, okay, let me check it out. And as soon as you get to this page, there's my $30 off, I know I'm on the right page, and I recommend that you do not have these menu choices for the visitors to a landing page. And we tested it. We tested it both ways here at Postcard Mania, because if you give them choices, they could leave your landing page without ever filling in your form, your lead capture form. So you want to give them as few choices as possible. Now, they can always, you know, like let's say this is ABC Tax Services. So if it's abctaxservices.com, it would be abctaxservices.com/special offer. Now, everybody who goes there knows that your website is abctaxservices.com and not, you know, that they could find it if they really want to. But we'd rather them do as we're telling them to do, and that's to fill out this form so we can get their contact information. So when you make a page, you have to make sure that there's always a place for them to fill in their email address. And make sure that this button, you see how it's purple and everything on the page is blue, yellow, red, or teal, yellow, red. By making this a totally different color than anything else on the page, your eye is really drawn to it involuntarily. So that would make somebody keep getting drawn back there, and that's where you want them to go, to your call to action, which is get your $30 off. You also, that's another point I should make, you want your button to say what it is they're going to get rather than the word submit or click here. You'd rather it be what they're going to get. Get your $30 off. I'll show you ours, and I'll tell you a little bit about it. So this is ours. We call Plan Your Direct Mail campaign. It's free. We call this our campaign planner campaign. And what we do is we only ask for an email address to get started, because if they go to the next screen, like we hit get started, and another screen will pop up, and I'll show you that in a second. If they don't fill out this screen, if they say, I don't want to give all this information, we at least have their email address. And we can follow up with just an email address and say, hey, you started to fill out the campaign planner form and then you got distracted. Here's a link to it if you wanted to continue. Or would you, you know, obviously you need help with your direct mail and we'd love to help you. You can call one of our direct mail consultants. I mean, there's, you know, so many different types of things you can put in an email to move the person to the next step. But it's really good to have just a simple email address only. You'll get a lot more people converting. You probably hear that word converting a lot. All that means is when somebody goes to your site, they're a visitor, and when they fill in their email address or anything, they've now converted to a lead. So you're always trying to increase the amount of conversion that occurs at your site. So we do the email address only, and then we have this pop-up, first tell us about yourself. And now the person feels like, oh, okay, you know, they may be slightly annoyed, but they're committed. I've already committed to finding out how to plan this campaign, so I'm going to fill out the rest of this form so I can keep going. Notice how none of our fields have any asterisks. I don't like when I'm forced to fill in a particular field on a lead capture form. I just want to do what I want to do as the visitor, as the consumer. So we feel like you'll get more information from them if you don't force them to put the information in. And that's why we don't have that, because every little thing that we do, we're trying to get someone to like us well enough to convert. So all you're doing with your marketing is you're first getting them to have some interest in what you have, and then every follow-up piece after that is to get them to like you more than they did when they first decided they were interested. So you use all these touch points to increase the amount the person likes you or likes your business so that they want to interact with you. So here, this is just to show you, and this is from Kissmetrics. This, if you put these little very famous and popular logos on your site, this will help conversion. It will help people fill out the form. So we call that social proof. That means other entities aside from you are saying this is a good company. So if, you know, we don't even know if this company was, you know, in the New York Times or what. I mean, I don't recommend putting logos up there if they're not true. But if I see these logos, I go, oh, wow, this is a super legit company. I'm more willing to fill out this form. Now, you don't have to, your logos don't even have to be that legit. You can use logos like for whatever associations you belong to, because the logos themselves and the names of the associations will, you know, give confidence to the person who's visiting. And I'll show you a little story. You know, you can test different things out on a for a fill-in form and see what works best. And I'll just tell you this little story. So the one on the left here was a fill-in form. Okay, so we did the same thing for years and years and years. We had only, well, this is a pop-up. If you went to my site, and after a few seconds, you would get this pop-up. And the pop-up said, direct mail marketing tips, $50 off your first order. And there was an email-only place to sign up. And then after you gave your email address, you would get this pop-up saying that we would give them samples. We would send them samples if they filled out the rest of it. I thought it was very professional looking. I didn't have any problem with it. But then I was remodeling my kitchen about 5 years ago, and I started going to all different types of websites looking for things for my kitchen, and one of the ones I went to was West Elm, and when I got there, after a moment, they had a pop-up, and the pop-up was hand-drawn, and I really instantly felt more compelled to fill out their hand-drawn pop-up than I was other pop-ups that I would see that were not hand-drawn. So I went to my office the next day, and I asked my designer if he would please come up with a hand-drawn pop-up and test it against the pop-up that we are currently using. And you can see we were getting 0.25% on the purple one. And then you can see when we switched, we were getting over 1% people filling it in. So that's a 400% increase from changing it to a hand-drawn pop-up. And we still use the hand-drawn pop-ups to this day. Okay, so now we're going to get to, now that you've gotten some data on how to get more people to fill out your form and get more email addresses, we're going to talk about follow-up and how important follow-up is, and also how to do it in a way that will be very little effort for you. So let's talk about importance of repetition. I know that you've heard that repetition of message is super, super, super important. So let's see what some well-known smart guys have said. One of the essences of PR and promotion is that you have to pound the same message home time and time again. A single ad, no matter how compelling, is almost never enough to sell your product. If you don't believe in your product, or if you're not consistent and regular in the way you promote it, the odds of succeeding go way down. So this is the single hardest concept for me to get small business owners to understand and implement. And I will say to you, if you think in your mind a certain amount of outflow of communication landing at your prospects, if you can think of an amount of direct mail or an amount of emails or an amount that you think is sufficient to really move the needle on your business, if you come up with a number, what you really need to do is 10 times that number in your mind. And this is the thing that really was different about me than other small business owners, because you saw my picture of when I first started, and I live in a, you know, not in a very big town, Clearwater, Florida, and there's a lot of people here that knew me then that know me now. And I can't tell you how many of them have asked me, like, how did you do it? How were you able to do it? How did you do it? Like business owners that have businesses that have just been staying about the same size or shrinking slightly or maybe growing slightly, but not, you know, at the speed that really gives them the life that they want. And the truth of the matter is that I am 100% willing to send out massive amounts of direct mail. And I always have been since the beginning. I always did more than what was comfortable for me, and it's truly paid off. But you have to have that repeat message. And back in the day, the only way for me to get that repeat message was either phone calls, individual phone calls, one-up emails, or mailing over and over and over again. Now, we still mail over and over and over again. I send out 160,000 direct mail pieces every single solitary week to promote Postcard Mania, but we also have some great follow-up, as you know. So let's take a look at this. Here's some follow-up statistics. 2% of sales are made on the very first contact. And we play a game here. I'll tell you something. We try to keep it higher than that here at Postcard Mania. My guys play all kinds of sales games, and we might do a little bit better than 2%. But this is like the first time they've called in. They may have been hit with a marketing message by us many times before they actually call in. So we're talking about, you know, 2% of sales are made on the first contact, the first ever contact, 3% on the second contact, 5% on the third contact, 10% on the fourth contact, but 80% of sales are made on contacts 5th through 12. And I don't, that 12 number is a little arbitrary to me. I feel like that's probably an average, but I'll hit the same list 100 times. I honestly will. I know that there are things that I've seen on TV where I've seen a commercial for it a zillion times, and I finally get the idea that I may want to order that thing. So, like, I did own a ShamWow. I don't know if you remember that commercial, but I did wind up getting one. But not necessarily the first time I ever saw the ShamWow commercial. So there's lots of tools you can use for follow-up. You can use email marketing, and there's lots of really good programs out there like iContact and MailChimp, and there's just a zillion of them. There's Infusionsoft where you can figure out, you know, exactly what you want to say to somebody after they've filled out your form and get some automated emails going to them where you can write them all at one time. And I'll tell you something. The first time I had to write all our emails, a bunch of emails, to put in a system of follow-up, I found it very daunting. And I sat down at my desk and I tried to write these emails, and it wasn't easy for me to do. So I wound up having a bunch of my staff stay late, and I had a pizza party, and I had a friend of mine also who's a good marketer come and join us. And we sat down and together, you know, we divided it up, like you write the emails for this and you write the emails for this. And then we kind of switched, you know, traded with each other to see what each other has written, which would spawn new ideas. So I suggest you do that if you're having trouble writing your emails. But you can see in the lower right-hand corner there, Direct Mail 2.0, and that is a beautiful automated follow-up tool. You also might be wondering about social media, so I'll just give you a minute or so on that. I don't feel, for my business, we do a lot on Facebook. I don't feel that we are really gaining a whole bunch of new business using social media. What we are doing is we're using it as a great follow-up tool. So anyone that goes to our website, we can, you know, have them see Facebook ads, and anyone who likes our, you know, we'll boost ads and use them to people who've already expressed some interest or have a particular demographic, but mostly it's people that are already on our list. And Facebook makes it really easy for you to show ads to people that are already on your house list. So we really use it for follow-up. Let me go over Direct Mail 2.0 because it's awesome. So this is an automated follow-up tool, and it has three components. We're adding three additional components to a traditional postcard or traditional direct mail piece. We're adding call tracking, mail tracking, and Google, and I'm going to go over all of those. So let's talk about mail tracking first. Mail tracking is a way for you to know when your direct mail piece is going to hit mailboxes and when it actually does hit the mailboxes. So we put a barcode, and you've seen this barcode. The post office has been providing this information for a long time, and they, we can take this information from the U.S. Postal Service and turn it into something you can see. So we have a portal that you can log into. It's on My Postcard Mania, and you can go in and see. You can see the blue part, which is now covered by the green part, but the blue part would be the projected date where the mail would hit the mailbox, and the green part are the actual confirmed dates of when the mail hit by zip code. And then the next thing I want to talk to you about is call tracking. Now, we had an interesting thing happen the other day. We had somebody on the phone with somebody who had done it. One of my marketing consultants was on the phone with a dentist that did a campaign with us, and she said, well, I don't feel like I got much business from it. And my consultant pulled up her call tracking records and showed her all that. Now, she can do this herself. You can go in and look at the portal and see all the calls that came in from your direct mail piece, and you can even listen to them. But she hadn't done that, even though she bought it. So my consultant showed her that hundreds of phone calls had come in from her direct mail piece, because the phone number on that piece is a special phone number. Now, we're just showing you our phone number here. You can have a local regular phone number. You don't have to have an 800 number. But the phone number on the card actually rings in your office, but it's picked up ahead of time in the cloud on a server and starts getting recorded. So let me just illustrate that for you. So here's the person calling your business. Here's a server in the cloud. They call it the cloud. And the phone call gets picked up, a record button gets hit, it's all automated, and then it rings in your business. And when that happens, you have all those calls recorded. So then you can go to the dashboard, and you can look at all the calls that came in, and you can click on the little triangle and listen to the calls. And that's what happened with this dentist. She listened to the calls, and she was kind of horrified, and she felt like her people that were working on her front desk were actually driving business away. She couldn't believe it. And this is not the first time I've heard the story, but I just heard this one today. This is one We resold her a campaign last week, and I just heard the, you know, this story today, but I have countless stories of this happening. And I have a really good customer in Orlando who's got a music school, and what he loves is that he's not there all the time. So if somebody calls the music school to ask questions and nobody's there, they hang up the phone, but it's already been recorded. So he can see who called in after hours, didn't get to speak to anyone, didn't leave a message, but now he can, he has that phone number there and he can call them back. So it's really an invaluable tool, and I would never send out direct mail without a call tracking number. But I feel like the most exciting part about direct mail 2.0 is the Google Follow Me feature. So let me show you how this works. So let's say you get a postcard in the mail. We're looking at this roofing postcard, and they receive this postcard and they're interested. So they go to the roofer's website, and at the website, they, even though this very smart marketer roofer has a 0% financing, it's a pretty good way to get someone to put in their email address to see if they qualify. And but the person leaves. They are part of the 96% that leave without doing anything. And then they go about their business. Oh, I'm going to go to Pinterest, and I'm going to do this, and I'm going to do that. And they go all over the internet. And a day goes by, and now they're, you know, on some other site. But what they're seeing is here, you can see they're seeing an advertisement that reminds them of their interest that they had originally. So now they go to another website, and there's another ad. And they are seeing ads, like, everywhere they go on the internet. There are literally millions of sites in the Google network where these ads will show. And this just, that's your repeat message in front of the person over and over and over again, and it, you don't do a thing. It's just part of your campaign. So they see your banner ad, and they may click right back to your site, or maybe they have the postcard on the fridge, and they're just going to call the number. But we can show you how many people saw your ad. It's very, very interesting. So direct mail 2.0 is really the best of both worlds. It's integrating your marketing. It's integrating direct mail with the follow-up of the Google Follow Me feature. It's also called retargeting or remarketing. You might have heard those terms, and that's what that is. And I'm sure it's happened to you. Like, if you go to Amazon.com or Nordstrom.com and you go looking at different products and you go to the product page but you don't actually buy it, you start seeing that product everywhere you go on the internet, and that's retargeting. So you can generate some really good leads and then follow up with them very affordably. It's fantastic. So let's show you how this works. So special code is added to your website, and what that code does is it cookies them. So I don't know why they call it an HTTP cookie or web cookie or browser cookie, and it's just a small piece of data sent from a website and stored there on the browser on their computer. And every time the user loads the website, the browser sends the cookie back to the server. Anyway, I don't want to get all technical with you. I don't know why they call it a cookie. It's not really a chocolate chip cookie. But when visitors come to your site, they're cookied and will start to see your ads. And when they go around, you know, to all the different websites that they go to. So basically, when visitors leave your website, they'll start seeing your advertisements all over the internet. So you have a much better opportunity to collect their contact information because they're going to be driven back to your site. Now, if you are not, if you are a doctor, a dentist, or any type of industry that's bound by HIPAA, we have something called the New Patient Edition, and what we do is, instead of retargeting or following people, because we're not allowed to do that, what we do are ads. We call them geo-targeted ads. They're basically going to all the same places your postcards are going, so the same people who went to your website or didn't go to your website but got your postcard are going to see ads all over the Google network. And what happens is these people, when they become a lead in the first place, we really don't know how hot or cold they are. I mean, they could be here and it doesn't take much to get them to close, but they could just be a cold lead. But over time, if you touch them correctly with good emails that are not super sales pitchy but are more helpful to them, eventually they'll like you enough to hopefully close. And now I'd like to show you some case studies, some real direct mail 2.0 case studies. So here's one for Farmers Insurance. The agent provided the list, and we mailed 6,000 pieces four times, and he wound up writing 60 new policies. The campaign cost him $11,000, but he made 60 grand off of it. Dobson Academy, they purchased 2,000 records of homes with children ages 5 to 11 and a household income of $35,000 to $150,000, and they mailed 2,000 pieces three times, and they enrolled seven students. And seven students for them is $25,000, and it cost them $3,300 to do that. And you can see here's their postcard, and here's their banner ad. So this is the postcard somebody would receive in the mail, and this is the ad they would see when they're traveling around the internet. Here's one where it was a dentist, so it was new patient edition. They did some radius around their practice. I guess I don't have that data specifically. They mailed 6,000 a month for 9 months. They got 337 new patients, which for them equaled $400,000 in revenue. They spent over $18,000 on the campaign. So you can see that was really terrific ROI. Here's our construction. I love these guys because Nelson Construction and Renovation is a local company here in Clearwater. They've actually did a bunch of work at my house, and I know they're awesome. So it's, you know, a lot of times those guys, they can market all day long, but if they're terrible, they're not going to have, they're going to have a bad reputation. These guys are really, really awesome. And one of the owners, the wife of the main guy, she came to our Growth Summit, and she literally implemented everything she learned at Growth Summit because I'm on their list. So, but she basically got a mailing list, 6,000 records, homeowners with an annual income of 100,000 plus and home value of 200,000 plus. She mailed three times. She got 30 responses and a million plus in new jobs. And the campaign cost her about $7,000, and she made a huge, huge amount. And here's my buddy Ahmed Khanna from Patuxent Dental. As I told you, he shares his revenue with me, so I love him to death. Just to show you the difference, when he was doing direct mail without direct mail 2.0, he was getting about 8 new patients per 1,000 cards. And when he added direct mail 2.0, it went up to just over 12 new patients per 1,000 cards. So he does really, really terrific with his. And here's that incredible graph. And this is where he had put in direct mail 2.0. And you can see the incredible growth that he had after that. Now, that brings us to the question answer time of my presentation, and if anybody has any questions, I think Jessica will let me know what they are. I wanted to tell you about a special offer that I have for you for being on the call, and basically, if you already have an order in progress, or if you're ordering for the first time, if you take your order in progress and increase it to a six-month campaign, I'm going to give you 25% off the additional spend that you have to do in order to make it a six-month campaign. And this is because I know that that's where you're going to get your best result, is by really committing to a long-term program. So if you've never bought from me before and you're thinking about it, now's the time. I know they're running some kind of special today called this week, and last week called Christmas in July, and that's another whole kind of offer if you don't do a six-month campaign. But I'd rather you do the six-month campaign, but they do have other offers going on if you don't do a six-month campaign when you call in. That phone number is a call tracking number. If you call that number, we will know that it was this webinar that generated the phone call, and that just helps us out. Or you can visit postcardmania.com/25-off, and we can track you that way. So I do practice what I preach. Now, I also want to tell you, before I take the questions, I want to tell you about the next Growth Summit we're having, which is September 20th to the 22nd. It's 2 days. The 20th, we have a cocktail party in the evening, and then the actual event is on the 21st and 22nd. We're combining the Growth Summit with our Dental Summit. The morning sessions will be separated, but then you'll all come together. So if you're interested in that, go to postcardmania.com/growthsummit. And hopefully you've been thinking up some questions, and you can ask them now, or you can email me, joy.genduza@postcardmania.com. I really do enjoy helping, and I have mostly all the positions in this company filled. I don't have to do the day-to-day work at Postcard Mania anymore, so this is where I get my pleasure from helping you guys. So there you go. Are there any questions out there, Jess?
Yeah, there are. There are a bunch that came in. We'll start with Dwight. He asked the first question. So Dwight was wondering, when you send out direct mail to the list, do you change the design of the piece, or do you use the same design each time you send?
Well, I'll tell you what. When I started my company, I'm a graphic artist, so I didn't, well, I'm not really anymore, but that's what I did to start this business, and I didn't have time to design more than one piece, so I literally mailed the same piece for years, and it was fine. And what you want to do is mail the same piece until you start. First, you'll see that the response is getting better and better as you mail the same piece over and over, and then you'll start to see the response is going down, and at that time, you can change up your design. And, you know, different people respond to different designs depending on, you know, the emotion on the card. I hate to say it, but negative superlatives, negative headlines actually get you a better response than positivity. Just shows you where we're at. So I would, you know, do a negative headline the next time to see if you get more, get some more responses from people who, you know, are there, are in the negative world. When I say negative, I mean something like, you know, don't read this postcard if you're blah blah, you know, or don't respond to this if you have blah blah, or something like that, like a negative thing.
Okay, cool. So we've got Frank is wondering, how much does Direct Mail 2.0 cost?
That is a really good question. It is as high as 13.5 cents per piece mailed, and it goes very low if you're doing hundreds of thousands of pieces. So I don't really know where the breaks are. You have to call and get a quote from one of my marketing consultants. I have like 37 people out there on the floor that can talk to you, and here's the thing. If you're thinking of calling one of my marketing consultants, please allow them to ask you a million questions. These guys are trained to put together the best possible campaign for exactly what you're trying to achieve for the lowest possible cost. And they are going to ask you a zillion questions, and they really do know what they're doing. So please do call them. Do take advantage of that. I mean, even if you decide not to do it, you'll learn something from having that conversation.
Great. So Rose is wondering, great stuff. Question, is the landing page / opt-in offer designed by Postcard Mania?
It can be, for sure. We do sell landing pages as a specific thing, and we'll help you come up with the offer. Like my marketing consultant will ask you a million questions. And when we're talking about an offer, you want to come up with something that has a very, very high perceived value that doesn't cost you very much at all. And because today we're so used to getting really great stuff for free, like Google and Facebook and Wi-Fi, you know, that we as a society expect a really great offer in order to respond to something. So make sure it's hard, sometimes hard to come up with something. But my guys will help you, because we have a lot of offers that we know already work across different industries.
Yeah, we compile, I think it's like, we just have hundreds of successful campaigns that you can steal offers and mailing lists and designs from. So definitely give somebody a call. Yeah. Let's see. We have a pretty technical question from Tyler, who sounds like a marketing expert in his own right. So Tyler's asking, how often will your banner ad be used on the sites within the Google network? Any research on a percentage of times your ad is used, as many businesses are doing the same?
I don't know what the answer. I know that it's shown thousands of times, you know, depending on how big your list is, but it is shown to each person that we, like, I have looked at enough I don't have them here in this PowerPoint or in front of me, but I can get you that data if you want to email me, Tyler, because I know that I can see that there were X number overall impressions and X number of people being followed, so I can show you that, and then you can see what the percentage is.
Yeah, and Tyler, I think that it might be based on, you know, where you're bidding, and we can have one of our online marketing experts work with you separately on getting your ad in front of all the other ads sort of in the queue. I know what you're going for, Tyler. So we can definitely work with you on that. Juliet is wondering, the phone number on the back on the postcard you track, would that be a separate phone number from the business number?
Yes, it's a totally different phone number, but it rings in your business right on the line where your normal number rings.
Awesome. Okay, this might be our second. Oh, Tyler says thank you, and he has been talking to Ian.
Oh, great.
FYI, yeah. Let's see. This might be the last question unless we have any others coming in. I know Joy's busy. So Juliet is wondering, does Postcard Mania work with your current logo, website, and color scheme to create a campaign that doesn't look dramatically different from your current designs?
Of course. Of course. We want it to all work together. So definitely. Thank you for asking.
Okay. I think that's it for questions. And I think, you know, you've shared so much knowledge with us already, Joy, that everybody's probably taking notes and calling somebody.
Okay. The other thing is if you guys want this PowerPoint, you can also email me, and we can send that to you as a PDF if you want to review it. So there's all kinds of things you can have, but I really want you to take the get the 25% off and do a 6-month campaign or longer. So thank you very much. Appreciate you attending.
Thanks. Bye, guys.
Bye.